Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. We are well into the fall season in Montreal. Every day I can feel the chill while breathing fresh air. It's my favorite season of the year. Not only do the fall colors of the maple leaves make the surroundings very beautiful, but also, according to TCM, fall is the best season to strengthen the lungs. There are many solutions in TCM to make your lungs healthier, such as adjusting your diet, taking some herbal supplements such as Tai Zi Shen or Pseudosterilis Radix, keeping a good mood, and so on. However, from the internal martial art perspective, you can add some exercises into your daily routine, including working on deep reverse breathing and movements that involve extending your chest. In my experience, such movements will strengthen lungs energy. So, I recommend you give it a try. The fall season is critical for your physical well-being during the rest of the year, which includes preparing for the winter. Especially in Canada, since winters here are very harsh. Today, I'd like to introduce a new concept, Zhuan Guan. Zhuan Guan is an interesting term used in describing some specific practice in the internal style of martial arts. Zhuan Guan is an advanced topic since many subtle details in practice are directly derived from it. Topics covered in today's video include: first, interconvertibility of yin-yang; second, history of Zhuan Guan; third, application of Zhuan Guan; fourth, basic principles of Zhuan Guan; fifth, demonstration; sixth, correction of students' practice; and seventh, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. Interconvertibility of yin-yang. Yin-yang is one of the fundamental concepts in Chinese philosophy, culture, and history. I have talked about yin-yang in many prior videos. Needless to say, it is an integral part of Chinese culture and has permeated the daily lives of Chinese people. The mutual rooting of yin and yang reflects the fact that they are interdependent and rooted in each other. In other words, one cannot exist without the other, and one's existence is the precondition for existence of the other. At the same time, yin and yang are mutually exclusive and restrictive to each other. The conflicts between yin and yang exist throughout the development process of everything in the universe. Furthermore, yin and yang are interconvertible under certain conditions. In other words, yang can transform into yin, and yin can transform into yang. So, in Chinese philosophy, yin and yang are a pair of dynamic concepts, and the ideal state of both yin and yang is to maintain a balance between them. In martial practice, we can analyze any movements based on the yin-yang concept. For example, a balanced stance should be in a state of equilibrium between the upper energy or the yang energy and the downward energy or the yin energy. A balanced stance is a very obvious example to illustrate the yin-yang concept. But it merely scratches the surface. That alone will not provide much help to your practice. Practitioners should pay special attention to the movements involving interconversion between yin and yang. In other words, the instant during which one movement changes its nature or to another movement altogether. Traditionally, That type of movement is called 转观. So, what is 转观? What is 转观 history? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 2, history of 转观. The term 转观 consists of two characters. 转 means turning, while 观 means gate or door.Together, it means a critical moment at which an object changes its nature. Originally, 转观 was a part of an ancient military device for controlling the movement of the device. The device was used as a bridge to a citadel. The mechanical part that controls the movement of the wheels was called 转观.Over time, people began to use the term 转观 to indicate the critical part of an object that serves a key function. For the last few decades, 转观has been used in the Tai Chi community. Unfortunately, it is not a popular term at all since it is not well known to most practitioners. However, to reach an advanced level in the internal styles,Understanding 转观 is essential, or else your practice will miss some key elements, which you will understand after watching this video. To the best of my knowledge, 转观was first introduced by Chang Nai Zhou, a prominent martial artist who lived from 1724 to 1783. Again, both 转观and Chang Nai Zhou.Are not very well known in the Chinese martial art community. Chang Nai Zhou wrote a book titled Chang Shi Wu Ji Shu, or Book of Chang Family Martial Techniques. I have to say that this book is one of the best in explaining martial theory and practice.All three internal styles have borrowed some key concepts from this book. For example, a lot of Xingyi concepts such as San Jian and the Bagua concepts such as De Men Er Ru are directly from this book. In this book, Chang Nai Zhou mentioned the term 转观 four times if I counted them correctly. For example, when talking about some important principles in martial art practice, he said,停顿处亦沉着有力，转观处亦活不随机。Translation: In the practice of martial arts, the structure should be solid and strong while pausing. Also, the movement should be dynamic and flexible while working on 转观. End translation. Even though there's no clear definition for 转观,Based on Chinese language structure and the meaning of each of the two characters, 转观 is the dynamic movement in the process of changing its posture, which is the opposite of a static posture. Chang Nai Zhou was the first person in history to use 转观 in a martial context. Then, what other martial artists talk about 转观?My research so far indicates Chen Xin provided the most elaborate details for 转观compared to any other martial art in history. Now, let's talk about 转观based on Chen Xin's Tai Chi book, which is one of the most important Tai Chi documents and the most important Chen style Tai Chi book so far. By the way, I have talked about Chen Xin in many of my Tai Chi videos.I recommended you check out my Tai Chi Overview playlist if you haven't already. Link is in the description. In Chen Xin's Tai Chi book, there are multiple mentions of 转观. 转观 is one of the key concepts in Chen Xin's writing, and we can see how important this term is in Tai Chi practice. Again, as is the case with many old martial documents,Chen Xin didn't provide a clear definition for 转观 in his book, but only explained Zhuangguan practice. That's why I'd like to provide my own definition of Zhuangguan. In the context of Tai Chi, Zhuangguan is the inner energy transformation between two energetic states in Tai Chi practice. This definition is a bit abstract, and I would like to explain my definition of this term. Now that we have looked at Zhuangguan in the context of Tai Chi, how about other internal styles? Please keep in mind that a concept can be known by a different name in a different practice, or not possess a name at all but still be expressed in a practice. Xing Yi and Ba Gua do not use the term Zhuangguan directly, but both of these styles have the same practice without using the same term. To summarize, Zhuangguan is the practice of inner energy transformation between two energetic states, which is Nei Jin, or the inner power expressed externally through subtle movements. If we use the Yin Yang concept to explain it, Zhuangguan is the transformational process of the Yin Yang energy interconvention, which is one of the fundamental functions and the nature of Yin Yang energy. Now that you know what Zhuangguan is, how do you apply Zhuangguan in practice? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 3. Application of Zhuangguan. Before going any further, you have to know that Zhuangguan is the concept and the broad category of movements, not any specific movement. In martial practice, a concept normally is derived from a conceptualized practice but can be explained by illustrations or demonstrations. So in this section, I will introduce how Chen Xin described Zhuangguan in his book. And then I will also talk about how Xing Yi applied Zhuangguan in practice. At the end of this section, I hope you will understand Zhuangguan better. Like I mentioned already, to the best of my knowledge, Chen Xin explained Zhuangguan in the most elaborate detail. So let me introduce what Chen Xin said about Zhuangguan in his book. Chen Xin used two famous sentences to describe an important martial strategy: 得势争来脉，出奇再转关。得 means take or achieve, 势 means advantage, 争 means control, 来 means incoming, 脉 means path of power. Put together, it means that in order to take control of an incoming attack, you should control the incoming path of the power. Chen Xin explained further by saying that in order to control the incoming attack, your own hand should be a bit higher than the opponent's. Also, your body should slightly push forward, making the opponent's position disadvantageous. He further explained that in order to control the situation, you have to 力贵速发，机贵神速, or power should be released very fast, and any opportunity should be grasped immediately. You can see that Tai Chi is not a slow art at all, as Chen Xin described it here. So, the four sentences tells us that in order to take advantage of the fighting opportunity, you have to act fast while being able to control the incoming attack by leading the power slightly higher than the opponent. Nowadays, we can call it an application's Peng Jin or word of energy. By investigating and analyzing Chen Xin's teaching, you should understand that the Tai Chi fighting principle is totally different from what people commonly assume. Now, let's focus on Chen Xin's second famous sentences, 出奇再转观。出 means demonstrating or showing. 奇 means unexpected or surprising. 再 means request or lets in. Put together, it means that demonstrating an unexpected surprising technique requires 转观。I have intentionally left 转观 untranslated here to focus on it. So, 转观 involves demonstrating an unexpected technique with internal energy transfer by external changing the path of power release. Recall that 转观 is the transformation of yin energy from one state to another, or from yin to yang.Or vice versa. So, the effect of the changing of energy state externally caused by internal change reflects 转观, an advanced level of Tai Chi practice. Chen Xin used the two sentences that we discussed just now to describe two martial application situations, including how to reach the opponent's incoming attack.And then how to manage the controlled attack by applying 转观 or turning gate, or changing the nature of energy and applying it to the opponent. Simply speaking, reaching the opponent's attack focuses on 起 or rising, while managing the attack focuses on 转 or turning. Chen Xin also said, quote,平素打拳，拳在一起一转。Translation, your daily practice depends on the rising and the turning. End translation. Actually, these are two very profound strategies in practice. By the way, in a prior video titled Decoding Martial Proverbs No. 8, first, speed versus progress, and two, Tai Chi Purchant,I introduced the Fu Gai Dui Tun concept provided by Wu Yuxiang, the founder of Wu Hao Style Tai Chi. If we compare both concepts, we can identify their similarities. Fu Gai Dui in Wu Yuxiang's concept is similar to Chen Xin's Qi concept, and the Tun concept provided by Wu Yuxiang can be consideredand as an example of Chen Xin's 转观. I recommend you watch that video. The link is in the description. Now you know quite a bit about 转观 in the context of Tai Chi. So, how about Xing Yi? Does Xing Yi have the same practice as Tai Chi? Of course. Xing Yi has a famous proverb, 起钻落翻.Which translates to fist rises with zhuan and falls with fan. The actions of zhuan and fan are just two specific forms of zhuan guan. Please keep in mind that zhuan and fan here are not limited merely to the fist, but in addition, they involve coordination with the inner energy change.In order to have the strongest impact on the opponent. So, Xing Yi uses different terms to express the same meaning. To get more detailed information about 起钻落翻, please watch my video titled Understanding Xing Yi, Ba Guo and Tai Chi Through Contrast No. 6, Key Movement Pattern in Fighting. Link is in the description. Now, you may be wondering,What about Ba Guan? Well, Ba Guan is the context of 转观 can be considered a combination of Xing Yi and Tai Chi. So, a lot of the concept and the practice in Xing Yi and Tai Chi can be applied directly in Ba Guan. I believe you have a better understanding of this term now. So, what are some important principles of 转观? That brings us to the next topic.Topic 4. Basic Principles of 转观. Like I have mentioned before, understanding the principles of a concept. In other words, understanding abstractions involved in other abstractions requires a lot more effort than usual. So, focusing on some key elements can make it more comprehensible. I'd now like to introduce two basic principles of Zhuanguan. First, 运进要缓，转观要急。运 means manifest or transfer. 进 means energy. 要 means should be. 缓 means slowly. 急 means fast. Put together, it means energy transfer should be slow, but 转观 should be fast. This proverb is used in both form and Pushan practice. It should not be applied in a self-defined situation since any combat involved activity should use full speed. So in the future, when you practice forms, you should pay attention to 转观 or any subtle movements involved with changing the nature of the inner energy, including direction, intensity, intended application, and so on. Slow motion practice helps to give the practitioner more opportunities to master the energy transformation and manifestation. However, when the inner energy changes its nature or the effect of applying 转观, it should be fast but still clear. By the way, I recommend you watch my video titled Internal Style Concept 18 Kuai Man if you haven't already. In that video, I have introduced the concept of fast and slow movement in practice. I hope you will apply Kuai Man in your practice going forward. Second, 逢转必沉。逢 means when, 转 means turning, 必 means must, 沉 means think. Put together, it translates to when turning, body energy must think.Please keep in mind that the term be or must does not mean that thinking is an absolute requirement. The word be used here is to emphasize the importance of a thinking motion, but some specific movements involving zhuan may not necessarily involve the thinking motion. However, most of the time, 逢转必沉as a principle should be applied when zhuan guan is involved since thinking is needed for power transfer in applying 转观. 转观 is implied in the word 转 in this principle. 逢转必沉 tells us that in 转观, the body should sink downward in order to not only stabilize the body structure for stronger power release, but more importantly,many turning motions may require the body to rotate around an axis. At a certain angle, and the sinking energy will make the rotation smooth and easy, which will enhance the 转观 effect in a martial application. Again, there are many other principles for 转观, but in the interest of time, I will introduce more in the future.To summarize, please try to apply these two principles into your practice. You will notice over time an improvement in the way you handle your 内劲 or inner energy. Topic 5, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a movement from the Chen Style Tai Chi first routine. It is the second Jin Gang Dao Zhui.Or Buddha's warrior attendant, Pang's Mortar. This movement starts from the single whip. Please pay attention to some 转观 movements made by the hand and the body. Hello, let me demonstrate the second 金刚倒锥 so that you can see the 转观 practice. So let's start from single whip. Focus on the lower 丹田 rotation. So at this place, if we start from here, in order to have the inner energy transformation, so slowly, 1, 2, then 3, then 1, Topic 6, correction of student practice. I'd like to correct the Xing Yi movement demonstrated by one of my students. Hello, let my student demonstrate Xing Yi Heng Quan or Earth Fist. Then I correct his movement. Now I can start. Slowly, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, again. Then turn. Okay, very good. Now you can move back from beginning, right? Start from beginning. And let's come to here. Yes, that's a better place. So slowly. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Now move back. Start again from here. Yes. So first of all, this angle should push like this. Look at here. Then second, extend further. Look at here. Then the hip here, down a little bit. Yes. Since instead of like this kind of sinking motion, then focus at this area. Now continue, 1, stop, then 2, continue, 2, stop. This one should go further, yes. Then 3, again, continue, 1, 2, 3. Now turn back, 1, 2, now slowly. Here should move under, then, yes. Now you look at, you come to here. I demonstrate for you. So 1, then 2, 1, then 2, 1. Right, 2, slowly, 1, 2. Yes, again, one more time. That's good. Now turn, put the force now. Yes, force. Then turn. Yes, then you can stop now. Yes, thank you. Topic 7, takeaways. First, interconvertibility of yin yang. Yin and yang are interconvertible under certain conditions. In other words, yang can transform into yin and yin can transform into yang, which is the theoretical foundation of some internal martial practice. Second, history of Zhuanguan. Chang Naizhou was the first person in history to use Zhuanguan in a martial context and then applied by Chen Xin directly. Third, application of Zhuanguan. All of the three internal styles of martial art apply Zhuanguan in practice, which is the effect of the changing of energy state externally caused by internal change. Four, basic principles of Zhuanguan. Two basic principles have been implanted, including, first, energy transfer should be slow, but Zhuanguan should be fast. And second, when turning, body energy must sink. Also, please do not forget to check out the demonstration and the correction of students' practice sections. That brings us to the end of today's video. Thank you for watching, see you next time, and enjoy your practice.